Felicidades. My brothers and sisters, let us begin our celebration of Camila in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.
And be with your spirit.
Del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, hoy estamos aquí en acción de gracias por Camila, unidos a tus familiares, amigos, recordamos el día que naciste para el mundo y el día que naciste para la iglesia por el bautismo. Todos agradecemos a Dios Padre haberte hecho hija suya y le pedimos que te siga acompañando para que lleguen a plenitud las semillas de santidad recibidas en el bautismo. Todos vamos a unirnos en un recordatorio de ese ideal que Cristo nos propuso al hacerse hermano nuestro. Y comencemos nuestra celebración con un momento de silencio para nuestro examen de conciencia. Por las divisiones o fronteras que hemos puesto a nuestros hermanos y hermanas sin reconocer que todos somos hijos del mismo Padre, llamados a formar la única familia, Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Por no ser servidores y olvidarnos de las penas y necesidades de los más necesitados, buscando siempre la comodidad para nosotros mismos, Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Por permitir que las tristezas debiliten nuestra fe, por el pesimismo que nos rompe la esperanza, por el egoísmo que nos hace dar la espalda a los hermanos, Señor, ten piedad.
Señor, ten piedad.
Dios nuestro, que a través del bautismo nos llamaste a tu vida de gracia, concédenos estar atentos a tu mensaje para que lleguemos a dar el fruto abundante que tú esperas de nosotros. Por nuestro Señor Jesucristo, tu Hijo, que vive contigo en la unidad del Espíritu Santo por todos los siglos de los siglos. Amén.
Amén.
Siéntese, por favor. Now we're going to have our first reading, please.
Lectura de la carta a los Efesios. Bendito sea Dios, Padre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que nos ha bendecido en Cristo con toda clase de bienes espirituales. Él nos ha elegido desde antes de la creación del mundo para ser santos y puros en su presencia por el amor. Él nos eligió desde el principio a ser sus hijos adoptivos en Cristo. Eso fue grandiosa generosidad. Derramó sobre nosotros su bondad al darnos el perdón de nuestros pecados y obtener para nosotros la liberación. Esto es palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Al salmo responsorial repetiremos: El auxilio me viene del Señor. El auxilio me viene del Señor. El Señor es mi luz y mi salvación. ¿A qué voy a tenerle miedo? El Señor es el refugio de mi vida. ¿Quién me hará temblar? El auxilio me viene del Señor. Si un ejército acampa contra mí, mi corazón no tiembla. Si me declaran la guerra, me siento tranquilo. El auxilio me viene del Señor. Una cosa pido al Señor, y esto soy, y esto estoy buscando, habitar en la casa del Señor por los días de mi vida, gustar de la dulzura del Señor y alabarle en su templo. El auxilio me viene del Señor. El Señor me dará cobijo en tiempo de adversidad. Me esconderá en lo oculto de su tienda. Sobre una roca me levantará. El auxilio me viene del Señor.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. And Mary said, "My soul give praise to the Lord, and my spirit rejoice in God my Savior, because he has regard for the lowliness of his maiden. Behold, henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is from generation to generation toward those who fear him. He has shown might with his arm. He has scattered the arrogant in the conceit of their hearts. He has pulled down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things. The rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the aid of his servant, Israel, and mindful of his mercy, just as he promised our fathers, Abraham, and his descendants forever." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Expected back then to get married and to produce warriors for the clan, okay, for the tribe, because they were always fighting and they needed warriors. So that when a girl reached 15, get married and produce warriors for the tribe, okay? That was the reason that they had a celebration at the age of 15. Now, times have changed a little bit. You are not getting married. And you are not going to produce warriors for the Cortes tribe. Now, we celebrate the quinceañera because we want you at this stage to renew your baptismal vows, okay? Your belief in God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and your belief that you are going to get rid of all evil things in your life, and you're going to be like Mary, the mother of Jesus, who was called to be mother at about your age. See? And she said yes. So that's what we're celebrating. How many others have celebrated quinceañera here? You're the only one. All these girls here were lining up, okay? You mean your grandma didn't celebrate her quinceañera? She did. Yeah. Oh, you did?
And she did.
So that's the reason for it, okay? You're going to renew your baptismal vows, which we're going to do now. And commit yourself to be, like Mary, a disciple of the Lord, okay? So will we do it? Let's have... You understand. Okay. to renew her baptism in us. Brothers and sisters, we accompany this young lady, Camila, in the renewal of her baptismal promises. She would like to express her belief in our church for herself. So, Camila, I ask you, do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Do you all remember what the communion of saints means? You do? That between the saints in heaven and us here on earth and the souls in purgatory, that there is communion, that we pray and look after each other. And you believe that. Good. This is the faith of our church, and we're proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And these are your renewal, the renewal of your baptism. Now we'll have the prayers of the faithful. We'll have all the prayers up there.
For the church, so that it might be a true family, open to the world, willing to embrace all men and women as a true mother would. Filled with charity and service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Okay.
For children, adolescents, and youth, that they may receive the necessary support from their families and society and be witness to Jesus as they grow in age. Wisdom and grace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Camila, who today offers her youth and renews her faith so that she may imitate the virtues of Mary and be a true apostle of the kingdom among her friends and companions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who work with our youth in different areas so that they may give guidance in accord with the values of the human person and commit themselves to responsibly accompany future generations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those among us who are burdened by some problem or sadness, that they may not lose hope and find consolation in knowing God our Father, we pray for the Lord.
Lord.
We pray to the Lord.
Now you may be seated. Okay. And at this moment, we're going to have the gifts of bread and wine and the flowers brought to the altar. And our young man is going to carry the cross.
There is darkness, only love.
Bible and the Rosary are the foundations of your faith. Here's the Bible, signifies faith in God, in yourself, and in the Word. Protection that will accompany you as you enter into this new phase of life. This rosary belongs to your great-grandmother, whom all your grandchildren call with affection, Mami. With this rosary, I bind you, Camila, to the Immaculate Heart of Mary for her guidance and protection. The rosary is a way to express your devotion to Virgin Mary and the Church.
Amen. Aplauso, por favor.
Father, I thank you for the gift of life, for creating me in your image and likeness, and for calling me to be your daughter through baptism. Thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, to save me, and your Holy Spirit to sanctify me. To that which in your goodness and love you wish for me, I say yes, amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, which will become our spiritual food. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Let us pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church. Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son, may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this holy day. He who now lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
You can remain standing, please. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
The Lord.
death, and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Gregory our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and her spouse, Saint Joseph, with Saint Francis, our patron, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now say together in Espanol, Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu santa voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo, danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación y líbranos del mal. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Mother of God and my mother, today I consecrate my youth to God through you. I come to learn from your Son. I want to live
values that Jesus lived. I want to safeguard his friendship and to work for his cause. Mother, help me to be a good woman. I want to say yes to God's plan in my life. I want to place my gifts in the service of others to help build a just and humane world. With your help and protection, dear Mother, I go forth into life to fulfill my duties. Intercede on my behalf that I may receive the blessings of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo, Santa Madre de Dios. Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo.
Please accept our thanksgiving as we join Camila. We wish to renew our vocation to life and service. Be with us, safeguard our hope that one day when we may be together in your kingdom with Mary our mother and with all your saints, you who now live and reign in glory forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
May he bless you this day and always. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Applause all the way for it.
Like to welcome you guys, the grandparents of Camila, Mili Agostini, escorted by Sergio Ramirez, known as El Chamberlain. Camila's grandparents, Ramon Cortez and Elena Toyens. Now I would like to welcome you, Camila's aunts, Beatriz Arevalo and Isabel Alfonso, and in representation of Camila's father, we would like to welcome you, Sandra Parra. Next, we would like to welcome you, Camila's godparents, Cynthia Cortez and Ramon Cortez. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me present the masquerade courtier of the birthday lady, Sandra Aquino Sanchez, escorted by Sebastián Cortés. Next, we have Dionisia Tusing, escorted by Sean Salgado. Next, we have Priscila Salgado, escorted by Mateo Gonzalez. Next off, we have the sister of the quinceañera, Ariana Diaz Cortez, escorted by Santiago Arevalo. Now we have Celeste Lusar, escorted by Roberto Morales. Bailey Simpson, escorted by Daniel Soto. Isabel Milan Rodriguez, escorted by Alex O'Donnell. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I ask everyone to please stand on their feet, and everyone please stand to welcome our quinceañera, Camila Alexandra Arevalo Cortez, escorted by her mother, Josefina Cortez. On March 22, 2002, a beautiful princess was born. With beautiful large eyes and a head full of hair, the beautiful Camila Alexandra came to discover the world. She grew very healthy. At 4 months, during a visit to Titi Blanca's house in New Jersey, Camila enjoyed her first taste of solid food. At an early age, Cami called herself Amila. Ari would also call her Maca, and her cousin Alex would call her Mika, because they couldn't pronounce her name. Imagine how confused she may have been. To try to help her learn her name, Theo Raymond would accompany Camila while she watched her favorite show, Dora the Explorer. On one episode, Dora was teaching Boots how to say down. In Spanish, abajo. So Theo instructed Camila to say abajo with the K sound, carajo, so she would learn how to say her name. She was a very strong girl from the start. At about 10 months, she jumped so hard out of her crib that later it collapsed. At 11 months, when her mother arrived to pick her up at Titi Mayra's house, Camila came to the door taking her first steps. After that day, there was no stopping her. Camila's early education included daycare at Pinocchio's Head Start at Oak Grove Elementary and K-5 at Mango Elementary. Camila always excelled at academics, always going above and beyond. During her young age, she danced ballet and began playing soccer by the age of 7. She attended Ferrell Middle Magnet School, excelling in all that she did. In 6th grade, she was awarded Rookie of the Year. In 7th grade, she received the Best All-Around Award. In 8th grade, she received the MVP Award. Ending her middle school years, out of everyone in her school, Camila Alexandra received the very prestigious Scholar Athlete Award. This is a very special award that honors a student that exceeds in athletics as well as in academics. She is currently attending Jefferson High School's Academy of Criminal Justice. We have all seen Camila grow and develop in many different ways. In soccer, playing Tampa Dynamo for the last 7 years. In church, she participates as an altar server, the children's choir, and the youth group. We are blessed that she has developed a beautiful relationship with God and that God has been her guide throughout the years. She is an amazing daughter, granddaughter, sister, niece, cousin, friend, coach, and teammate. I want you to know that I am very proud. Josie wants you to know that she is very proud of being your mother and all of your accomplishments. Even in hard times, you have overcome multiple challenges and obstacles that have helped you to grow and become stronger and a unique you. On this day, we celebrate the beautiful young lady you have become. Let's give Camila a round of applause. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you guys can please take your seats, we are going to begin the sword ceremony.
Hello, everyone. I am Camila's tío Raymond, and this is our sword ceremony. Now, you might wonder, what exactly is all this? Well, Camila, when Camila was born, or rather, when she was about close to 5 months of age, they brought her down to Puerto Rico to meet me. And I remember her, little teeny Camila in her little carrier, looking up at me, and all I can think of was, she reminded me of a little Japanese doll I had. You know, that decorated my own collection of katana, because I'm a big Japanese aficionado. And as the years went by and I kept coming up to Tampa to visit her, you know, she reminded me of a character from a movie I saw a long time ago, a favorite movie of mine, and I used to call her Yaimon. She reminded me of the son of the Taiko in the movie Shogun. So I said, well, when you turn 15, I'm going to get you your sword, just like he did. And it kept repeating. It was a little trend. At first, it was a joke. But I guess I'm a man of my word. And there were too many witnesses. So I figured, okay. So the time came. I got her sword. So for this quinceañero, for the Japanese, it's called a genpuku, which is a coming of age. And in the genpuku, normally, in the age of the samurai, which of course samurai were the ruling class of the time, first during the Heian period, then the Sengoku, then the Tokugawa or Edo period, and then the Meiji period, they were the ruling class. They meted out justice like the knights of old Europe, and they followed a code very similar to our code of chivalry, but it was called the Code of Bushido. To the samurai, the sword represented the soul of the samurai, and also their honor. And for Camila, or rather, in the Code of Bushido, they also followed, because they were very strictly Buddhist and Shinto, they followed eight virtues, which are embedded in the swords. The main sword, which is the katana, embodied, it's in here somewhere, was the embodiment of honor. Now, nowadays, honor doesn't really mean a hill of beans to a lot of people. So there's a synonym, or something synonymous, which is integrity. And, along with that, there's also filial devotion, duty and obligation, wisdom, loyalty, courtesy, and sisterly affection. With the second sword, which with the two swords, because samurai always carry two swords, called the daisho. The second sword represents, Camila, your faith
in God
and your commitment to Holy Mother Church, as well as your sympathy and your benevolence. Now, the smaller sword,
which is more of a glorified
dagger, really, is called the tanto. Now, the tanto doesn't really mean, I mean, you look at it, it looks insignificant. But it's supposed to represent you. We live in a very big world. And just as that blade can cause a mighty impact, you have created a great impact on all these people here. To me, as you know, as a beautiful niece and goddaughter, to your mom and your dad as their daughter, friends, family, you know, cousins, everybody. Everybody's here because they love and they care about you, and they wish to honor you. And I want to honor you with this, because after all, believe it or not, I had no idea, but Camila is of Japanese descent on her paternal grandmother's side. So that's probably about a quarter Japanese? And I'm not good with fractions. So my little Japanese, Camila Hime, do you accept my gift? Hi. Okay. So if you please, so everybody, to my dear Princess Camila, Camila Hime. And that concludes the ceremony.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, our masquerade courtier will perform their special dance.
Thank you.
Alrighty, Kamiwami. So as a little surprise, me and your mom made a special video for you, and it's basically a recap of your life. And your mom wanted me to sing this special song to you, My Baby You, because you're all of our baby. We love you. As I look into your eyes, I see all the reasons why my life's worth a thousand skies. You're the simplest love I've known, and the purest one I'll own. No, you'll never be alone. My baby, you are the reason I could fly. And 'cause of you, I don't have to wonder why. My baby, you, there's no more just getting by. You're the reason I feel so alive. Though these words I say are true, they still fail to capture you, as my words can only do. How do I explain your smile and how it turns my world around? Keeping my feet on the ground. My baby, you are the reason I could fly. And 'cause of you, I don't have to wonder why. My baby, you, there's no more just getting by. You're the reason I feel so alive. Oh, I will soothe you if you fall. I'll be right there if you call. You're my greatest love. My greatest love of all. You are the reason I could fly, and because of Camila, we have one more special surprise for you. So although we cannot all be there to celebrate in the physical, we are there to celebrate with you and celebrating with you in the spirit. And we just have a very special message for you.
Corazón. Hoy en este día tan especial, le pedimos a Dios que te siga llenando de bendiciones. Quiero que sepas que nos sentimos muy orgullosos de tener a alguien como tú. Desde la distancia. Ay, Dios mío. Desde la distancia te acompañamos en este día y esperamos lo disfrutes como tú te lo mereces. Te queremos y que Dios te proteja siempre. La verdad, me cuesta mucho trabajo poder decirte que me da mucha tristeza no haber podido estar contigo. Que Dios te bendiga.
Hey, Cami. I just wanted to wish you a very happy birthday. Obviously, I can't be there because I'm out here, you know. And just want to let you know I love you with all my heart, and God bless you now and always. And I really hope you have a special day. All right, I love you.
Buenas noches. Primero que todo quiero darle gracias a Dios por la oportunidad que nos ha dado de poder compartir con todos ustedes este tan especial momento para nuestra familia. Creo que para nosotros como padre es uno de los más importantes que podemos tener en nuestra vida, y para mí como papá de una princesa es uno de los más emocionantes, de los más felices, pero también a la misma vez de los más preocupantes, porque me empiezo a dar cuenta que esta nena que he visto llorar, que la he visto gatear, que la he visto caminar, que la he visto correr y que la he visto luchar, se me empieza a convertir en una señorita. Pero estoy totalmente seguro y tranquilo porque tengo toda la confianza puesta en ella y sé que va a ser una gran y exitosa mujer para este mundo. Entonces, pues, para ti, princesa linda, quisiera decirte que te quiero mucho, que tú sabes y sabes que puedes contar conmigo, que siempre voy a estar allí para cuando tú necesites, que me hace sentir el padre más feliz y orgulloso del mundo, que sé que todo lo que te propongas lo vas a lograr, porque nada de lo que tú hagas o de lo que tú te propongas te va a quedar grande, eso lo tenemos claro. Sabemos que vas a empezar una nueva etapa en tu vida, y como te dije, como te he dicho, no es fácil, pero tampoco es difícil, y tenemos muchas personas alrededor de nosotros que nos quieren, que nos aprecian y que nos aman, y estas son las herramientas que nos da Dios también para apoyarnos y poder salir adelante. Pues no queriendo alargar más esto, yo quisiera decirte solamente que tengas un feliz día, que disfrutes al máximo, que goces esta celebración con tus amigos y con tu familia. Y también quisiera hacer un paréntesis un poquito y darle las gracias a todas esas personas que siempre han estado a tu lado, que siempre te han apoyado, tu abuela Mili, tu tío Ramoncito, tus titis, tus tíos, Sandra, y de todo corazón de parte mía, muchísimas gracias. Y nada, mi amor, solamente disfruta tu día al máximo, nos vemos en el verano, como siempre, te quiero muchísimo, sabes que eres mi princesa y seguirás siendo mi princesa. Y pues no siendo más, Dios los bendiga a todos, Dios te bendiga, yo te echo la bendición y seguiré pidiendo a Dios para que te guarde y te proteja todos los días. Muchos besitos, te quiero mucho.
Is the symbolization of a young lady, a little girl turning into a young lady. And we are doing it together. Sandra helped me the first 2 years of Camila's life, and still to this day has. So that's why I have asked her to help me.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to begin the mother-daughter dance with Camila and Josie, dancing to In My Daughter's Eyes.
The truth is plain to see, she was sent to rescue me. I see who I want to be in my daughter's eyes. Darkness turns to light, and the world is at peace. This miracle God gave to me gives me strength when I'm weak. I find reason to believe in my daughter's eyes. And when she wraps her hand, a reflection of who I am and what will be. And though she'll grow and someday leave, maybe raise a family, when I'm gone, I hope you'll see how happy she made me. For I'll be there in my daughter's eyes.
Salvo, Mi primer ilusión y mis vidas de amor son iguales en el mar. Una tarde me fui a un extraño nacido, nuestro destino. Pero mi corazón se quedó en el mar, en mi desamor. A todos. Thank you.